What a Wild Watch. I'm the Wild. We're at Addington on Tuesday. Yes, it's Cup Day there. We've done a suggested multi for a Cup Day special. $20 could return $430. Let's have a look at those three next on WW. I think the best bet of the day goes early, and it's in race number three. It's a junior free-for-all. The bookmakers have opened up Triple Eight just under $3. I thought its Kaikoura run was super. Let's go and have a look at that run. Coming to the very outside, the last half was 55.9. He made good ground. Let's bring Matt Cross in for the last 150.
Cruise Bromax sticks on. Inside run another masterpiece. Then came a better act. Winding up late, Triple Eight and Hale Christian to the outside. Still Classy Brigade. Leads at half a length, Cruise Bromax. Another masterpiece in Triple Eight. But it's Classy Brigade's Kaikoura Cup. Classy Brigade for John and Robert Dunn. Beat home Cruise Bromac. Third in was Triple Eight.
Well, he couldn't be more impressive, could he? Hit the line really strongly. It was just a sprint home. Last half, 55.9. I think the bigger track at Addington will suit. His main danger's drawn inside him in the form of Better Act and, of course, Ultimate Sniper. Let's get to a horse that I thought's been in great trial form. It was at Rangiora 3 weeks ago, and its name is Belmont Major. Let's have a look at that trial. In this trial is Triple Eight, so it's a really good video to your show. You can see him getting to the centre track. He hits the line very nice in a very quick last half. Richard Bromley will take you through the last 100 metres.
To the front, leads Matt Damon, who fights back. They're followed by Triple Eight, Matt Damon. And on the centre track is Belmont Majors running home pretty resolutely. Triple Eight, Belmont Majors, a dying colour down the outside. Triple Eight's in front, Belmont Majors trying to get it on the outside, but Triple Eight will hold on to win just over Belmont Major. They're followed by Check and Smoke and Reactor, Matt Damon, Copperhead Rose.
So he hasn't had race since July, but he's had two really nice trials. Of course, Cup Day trials on Wednesday. He ran a very impressive last quarter in defeating Italian Lad. So he's on form, and he's got the right draw and the right driver in John Dunn aboard. Let's go to the Cup itself. I reckon the horse that won the race last year can win again. It's named the Fixer. Let's go back to what is traditionally the best lead-in run to the New Zealand Cup. It is the Flying Stakes, and here he is in front. His main rival, Spankham, is in the trail. You've got Self-Assured getting to the outside. Cruise Matt Cross takes you through the last 150 metres of the Flying.
300 metres to go. Spankham the inside, and look at Self-Assured descend upon them. Spankham gets up the lane. Self-Assured wide out. The Fixer in the middle from Chase Auckland. Spankham up the Sweet Lou passing lane. Took the lead over the Fixer. Wide out is Self-Assured, but the Cup favourite wins the Flying Stakes. Spankham by a length. Beat home the Fixer. Third in Self-Assured, and he was massive. Then came Chase Auckland.
It was a super run in the Flying Stakes, wasn't he? He's backed that up with a nice Cup Day trial behind race rival Spankham. He's such a good beginner. He's got a front row draw. It does look illogical, Quinella, with the All-Stars runners Spankham and the Fixer. I think he can chuck in Cruise Bromac. And I think the Northerner's best chance is Max Shard, who got to the line quite nicely in winning the Holmes DG. Let's have a look at the three for you. Cup Day, our $20 multi-special. Starting early on in race number four, the junior free-for-all. We really like Triple Eight, the 290. Best of the day. Into Belmont Major, I think he's the multi-maker at 240. And our Cup Day tip, it is the Fixer. He's at $3.20. That $20 suggested multi, $430.